Katakan saya boleh membawakan kelimpahan kekayaan kepadamu.
Deuteronomy 28 says,
dan Ulangan 28 mengatakan,
all these blessings shall come upon you and overtake you.
Segala limpah berkat ini akan datang kepadamu dan juga akan melebihimu.
I want to tell a last story of that old evangelist R.W. Schambach.
Dan cerita yang terakhir saya ingin kongsikan lagi kepada daripada Schambach, penginjil Schambach.
One night he's taking another offering to continue the ministry.
Satu kali lagi dia ingin menerima penyembahan pemberian untuk meneruskan pelayanan kepada Tuhan.
There was a man who had a trucking business.
Ada orang ini dia ada bisnis bawa lori.
But his truck was so old he had to lay hands on it to start in the morning, pray over it.
Tapi lori itu sangat tua sampai dia perlu berdoa tumpang tangan kepada lori sebelum dia kasih start itu enjin.
He had $400 in his wallet that he was trying to save for a truck.
Dan dia ada $400 di tangannya yang dia cuba simpan untuk beli lori baru.
But he said God, it's going to take so long. He said I'm going to give it to you and believe you to bless me somehow.
Tapi dia katakan Tuhan ini akan mengambil banyak masa, tapi saya akan memberikan kepada kerajaan Tuhan. Dan saya percaya kamu akan memberkati dengan saya dengan satu cara macam mana pun.
He left the meeting and began to get in his truck and drive home.
Dan dia pun meninggalkan apa perjumpaan itu dan ambil lori dia dan bawa balik ke rumah.
As he's driving in the dark, thinking God spoke to him.
Dan semasa dia drive itu lori pada waktu malam Tuhan bercakap dengan dia.
He said, "Stop your truck. Get out, lift the bonnet, and have a look down in the carburetor."
Dia katakan berhentikan lori itu, buka bonnet dan tengok di bawah carburetor.
He did that. He looked. He couldn't see anything in the dark.
Dia pun buat itu. Dia pun buka bonnet, tengok carburetor tidak boleh nampak apa-apa. Sebab gelap malam.
God said, "Now put your hand down here under the carburetor."
Dan terus tersebutlah Tuhan bercakap dia, letakkan tangan kamu di bawah carburetor.
He felt a cylinder thing like an oil filter.
Dan dia macam terasa ada sesuatu peti, macam satu filter minyak.
But it was the wrong side for the oil filter.
Tapi oil filter bukan di sebelah sini, di tempat yang sebelah.
He began to wriggle it and it broke off.
Dan dia cuba kasih gerakan dan dia terus boleh dapat itu peti.
It was something covered in grease.
Satu peti itu penuh dengan minyak.
He brought it into the cabin of the truck and began to open up the paper.
Dan dia pun kasih masuk dalam cabin ada punya lori dan tengok tu buka itu bungkusan.
And wrapped up in that paper was $26,000 in $100 notes.
Dalam itu simpanan ada $26,000 dalam dolar Amerika.
How did it get there?
Macam mana ia di sana?
I don't care how it got there.
Saya tidak kisah macam mana ia boleh tersimpan di sana.
God is a miracle worker.
Tuhan adalah Tuhan keajaiban.
God wants to bless people.
Tuhan ingin berkati orang.
God is not afraid to bless his people.
Tuhan tidak takut untuk berkati umatnya.
Money is not evil.
Duit itu bukan jahat.
It is the love of money that is the root of all evil.
Tetapi cinta akan uang itu adalah segala akar kepada kejahatan.
When God blesses and we go, it's mine.
Kalau Tuhan berkati kamu dan katakan ini saya punya.
But when God blesses, say thank you Lord, I need some for this. Here's to you. Let me help this person here.
Tapi kalau Tuhan berkati kamu dan katakan, oh, okay, ini untuk Tuhan, ini untuk kerajaan Tuhan. Ini saya mau bantu ini orang, saya mau bantu itu orang.
God says I can release more to that person.
Dan Tuhan boleh mempercayai saya boleh melepaskan lagi banyak berkat kepada orang ini.
Because God wants to bless his people.
Karena Tuhan ingin berkati umatnya.
Had a girl come to my church in New Zealand.
Ada seorang perempuan yang datang kepada gereja saya di New Zealand.
Brand new convert, never been to church.
Baru percaya Tuhan dan tidak pernah datang gereja pun.
She was coming for a couple of months.
Dia datang selama beberapa bulan sudah.
She had a part-time job that didn't pay much money.
Dia ada satu kerja part-time yang kurang sedikit gaji dia.
She rang me one day and said, "Pastor, I got a revelation."
Dan dia call saya, "Pastor, saya dapat satu pemwahyuan pemahaman."
I'm going to obey God and give a tenth of my income.
Saya akan mentaati Tuhan dan bagi persepuluhan 10% daripada saya punya pendapatan.
I said, "Praise God, good on you, Janine," and that was it.
Dan saya katakan, puji Tuhan, baguslah kamu itu Janine, dan saya itu saja.
An hour later, she rang me up.
Dan satu jam lagi dia call saya.
She said, "Pastor, I just lost my job."
Pastor, saya baru hilang kerja.
She said, "But I'm still going to believe God."
Tapi dia katakan, saya akan masih percaya Tuhan.
2 weeks later, she got a full-time job.
Dua minggu kemudian, dia dapat satu kerja sepenuh masa.
With a rental car company.
Dengan satu kereta kereta sewa.
They liked her so much that in a week they gave her a promotion.
Dia suka betul ini perempuan sampai satu minggu dapat naik pangkat sudah.
More money.
Banyak lagi gaji, banyak duit.
A month later, they gave her another pay rise.
Dan satu bulan lagi dia bagi lagi kenaikan gaji.
More responsibility, more money.
Lebih banyak tanggung jawab, lagi banyak duit masuk.
3 months later, she rang me.
3 bulan kemudian dia call lagi saya.
She said, "Pastor, I'm making so much money, I don't know what to do with it."
Dia katakan, "Pastor, saya banyak betul dapat gaji, saya tidak tahu macam mana lagi mau atur ini duit."
God's able to bless His people.
Tuhan dapat memberkati umatnya.
If you would simply believe God and obey God.
Kalau kamu sangat simple mentaati Tuhan dan mempercayai Dia.
Many of you people are very liberal people.
Banyak orang di sini bermurah hati.
And God is going to bless you for that.
Dan Tuhan akan memberkati kemurahan hati kita.
God is a creator of wealth.
Tuhan menciptakan kekayaan.
God can bring large resources into KK.
Dan Tuhan boleh membawakan satu kelimpahan kepada KK.
Our church in America, where our fellowship began.
Dan gereja kita di mana persidangan gereja ini bermula di Amerika.
A little poor country town.
Satu kampung yang miskin.
But God has brought incredible businesses into that town. Big companies have come in.
Tapi Tuhan telah memberkati karena satu perkampungan itu dengan banyak syarikat yang melaburkan bisnis di sana.
It is a prosperous place today.
Satu tempat yang penuh dengan kekayaan.
God's people are prosperous.
Orang anak-anak Tuhan penuh dengan kelimpahan berkat.
God wants to bless His people.
Tuhan ingin memberkati umatnya.
God wants to bless you.
Tuhan ingin memberkati kamu.
Let's bow our heads tonight. Let's close our eyes for a few moments tonight.
Dan mari kita